Now, moving forward, we have Ants of Matrix. So this was proposed for strategic management in a creation of matrix that quantifies growth in market, goods, and services. So the Ants of Matrix helped many corporations get a clear view of the uncertainties involved in the development of their firms. So these are the following strategies in Ants of Matrix. We have number one, marketing or market penetration. So in order to achieve market share, the concentration is on selling existing goods or services to existing markets. Like for example, si Jollibee, existing goods yung Chicken Joy and Yum Burger niya. Then, accepted na rin siya ng existing markets. So, ang finocus lang niya doon is the distribution of existing goods. If they will be launching a product, that is another strategy. So, punta po tayo ngayon sa market development muna. So, the concentration is on finding new markets or consumer segments for the existing goods or services. Doon sa article analysis natin, they expanded their branches internationally. Pero ang binibenta nila is existing goods. Existing siya in a sense na produkto na yun ng Jollibee dito sa Pilipinas. Na ina-adapt lang or ina-extend rather, ina-extend doon internationally. Okay? Then, ang ibig sabihin niyan, it assumes 50% risk since the existing goods were not yet fully accepted by new markets. Bakit po siya hindi pa accepted ng new market? Kasi first time mong mag-launch ng Filipino food or Filipino fast food restaurant or menu sa ibang bansa. So, will their taste buds accept the taste of Pinoy food or Pinoy chicken? Next is the product development. So this one is the Ants of Matrix perspective. The concentration is on designing and launching of new goods or services for the existing markets. So innovation, hindi discuss yun, next chapter, and yung also yung product development. But pero this assumes 50% risk since the existing markets haven't fully accepted the newly added native delicacies, for example, puto doon sa Jollibee. Gusto nilang i-add ang dinuguan at puto, for example lang ha, sa menu nila. Therefore, that's another product. Pero existing yung market mo kasi meron ka ng branch ng Jollibee, for example, sa San Jose or sa Rizal. Tapos, gusto mo lang i-implement yung product mo na or i-launch ang product mo na puto. So, bakit tayo gumagawa nun ng new product? Kasi yung saturation point, pag sinabi natin saturation in Filipino, that is the pagkasawa point. So, dahil sawang-sawa ka na sa menu, of course, naghahanap ka ng bago. Then, this one is to break down that saturation point. If you remember, si Jollibee naglo-launch siya ng Aloha Burger pero hindi siya always available. So that is limited edition. And that is one type of product development na nagbe-breakdown sa saturation point ng mga burgers ng Jollibee. So that is a redesigning of product. Kasi existing na yung product eh, may burger ka na eh. So you redesign it by just adding certain toppings like pineapple, and other topics. Next thing, we have diversification. So, meron two types yan. We have related and unrelated. So, punta muna tayo sa diversification. So, the concentration is on designing and launching of new goods or services to sell into new markets. So, ito yung pinaka-risky, ang diversification. Kasi wala ka pang data dyan eh. Kumbaga, entry point ka palagi kapag diversification. So, sa two types, we have related. there is overlap between a company and a new product or market. For example, si Jollibee nilaunch mo sa Gabaldon, so that's new market. Related diversification, ang mga produkto lang na offer doon would be, for example, ay so sa Gabaldon Jollibee, gusto mong i-testing naman itong new product launching mo ng sisig, Jollibee sisig. Diba? So si Jollibee sisig ngayon is related diversification kasi nasa product line ng food business siya. Unlike sa unrelated diversification, unrelated siya sa core business. For example, si Jollibee naman ay maglo-launch ng Jollibee car. Okay, Jollibee motorcycle. Unrelated siya kasi ang product line mo kay Jollibee is food. Then, mapupunta ka sa vehicle industry.